I never met John Paul II, never had the opportunity, but he meant the world to me. I joined the college seminary in the fall of 1978. When I was interviewing for the seminary, Paul VI was Pope. When I went through the doors of the seminary, John Paul I was Pope. And by October of that year, John Paul II was Pope. So he was Pope during all those years of my seminary training, all the years of first 19 years of my priesthood. And what a model to have. I'll tell you, the first time I laid eyes on him was the following year. So it would have been the fall of 79, just after the events that Rocco was describing. That was June of 79. This would have been like September, October. John Paul came to Washington. And by that time, I was at Catholic U as a student of philosophy. So we were all out on the front of theological college facing the shrine in Washington. John Paul arrived. And you know, people younger than I don't remember the John Paul superstar era. A lot of people, if they remember him, they remember maybe the very old and infirm John Paul. But I remember 1979, he was, what, 59 years old. You could tell he was both an actor and an athlete, full of life, standing in the car and exuding confidence and joy. He comes to the front steps of the shrine, and we're all shouting, all the kids are shouting, John Paul II, we love you, right? So finally, he comes to the microphone and he says, John Paul II, he love you. But then he said, he love you more because he love you with microphone. So that was the first time I experienced him. And then the following day, there was mass at the mall in Washington. And I'll never forget, it was a very cloudy day, overcast. But then suddenly there was John Paul, and he was standing up in the car and was moving along one of the streets there toward the mall. He had the white cassock, he had the red cape, again, exuding confidence. And as he came by, I remember the sun came out. And he delivered this extraordinary homily that day. You can look it up, 1979 on the mall in Washington. But we all knew, okay, there's something new. There's a fresh wind blowing in the church. There's this great personality. And I'll use it in von Hildebrand's sense, right? This great personality had emerged. And I just say, one of the great blessings of my life was that that personality emerged precisely when I was entering the seminary. And he was the lodestar for me and many people in my generation. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to share it and be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel.